What's up guys, Blair Tetchy here, back with an all new video. Today, I'm actually gonna go over a topic that one of my buddies brought up this week that I think a lot of you guys are really gonna appreciate. So we're gonna be covering how to start a Pokemon card collection. For those of you guys that have already been in the business a long time of collecting, this probably won't be suitable for you, but if you do wanna stay tuned to the end of the video, we are gonna have a couple of booster packs opening. We got Unbreaking Bonds, we have Team Up, and then we have some Roaring Skies that we did pick up today. So if you wanna just skip to that, I'll put a link in the description. You can go ahead and just skip to that. That way you don't have to see the beginning. So anyways, first thing we're gonna cover, like I mentioned, is how to start a Pokemon card collection. Where do you start? So, personally, where I would start before anything, if you're gonna be a serious collector, is getting yourself an album. Now, you can pick up any regular album at Walmart or Target. They usually have some that are just plain. I got this one off of Amazon. Amazon has a lot of different ones that you can choose from, especially if you're going for a Pokemon theme. However, do keep in mind, if you're going for one that has a graphic design in the front, a lot of the times, they're only about this big. Now, this is not to say that this isn't big enough, but if you want like an actual huge binder, they do have bigger ones, but 9 times out of 10, at least for me, I haven't seen them with graphics in front. So this is one of my binders. It has different kind of cards inside of here, and I'm gonna go over exactly how I organize them, because that's another big thing when it comes to the collecting. The biggest thing in collecting is knowing what you have left to accomplish for that pack, at least for me personally. And a lot of the things that we're going to cover in this video, guys, like I said, it's just my preference of doing things. It's my opinion. You guys might have a better way to do it or just a different way to do it, but this is the way that I like to collect. All right, so the first thing we're going to cover, and this kind of ties into the first thing that we covered, you're going to have some of these Ultra Pro 9 pocket pages. You don't have to necessarily get that Ultra Pro brand. But I do like that brand because they're pretty sleek. I don't notice a lot of them falling than the cheaper brands. The cheaper brands, a lot of the times when you put them in, they'll slip out. So that is a good brand. This was one of the albums, like I mentioned earlier. It doesn't really have any graphics in it, but as you can see, it's a lot bigger than the other ones and you can fit a lot more cards into it. And then this is another one that I have here. So this one I got off of Amazon as well. And these are usually pretty cheap. They go for like about $10 to $15. This one I think I got for close to $20, but it did come with that. So you get about 100 pages, I'd say. So we're gonna get straight to the organizational part of this. So what specific order do I use for organizing cards? So here's the easiest way. When you look down here, and I'm gonna go ahead and take a second to focus on that, you see a symbol and a number. So for example, this is 1 out of 122. Now what you want to do with that symbol is you're going to look up exactly what card pack this belongs to. So if you're opening up the card packet right then and there, it'll be easy. A lot of the times it's hard to memorize them, but after collecting for so long, you do remember these. And then what you're going to do is you're going to put them in order. So as you can see here, that's card number one. The reason why I skipped this one is because I don't have two in that set. But then if you look over here, you have the third one. So that's Meganium. And then you got Chikorita. So that's the easiest way that I order them. As you can see, you know, you'll have, this should be 16 down here, just because here this will be 17 and 18. You can fit 18 cards in an entire page. So that's the easiest way to remember it. You just do multiples of 18. And then let's say you don't have like an entire second page because you're starting a brand new card packet. Just skip it, put a an empty page in there, and then continue adding the cards, you know, as if those cards were already there. This is the easiest way that I like to do it because as I continue to get cards for that pack, I'll continue to fill these, you know, these empty slots right here. And then this is the best way that I'm able to see I'm missing, you know, maybe 20 or 30 cards from this pack. And then if you're the type of collector that doesn't necessarily want to wait on just getting packs, you know, to be able to get all these cards, and you'd rather just go, you know, to a website, for example, a third-party website, and order cards so that you can fill these in, this is the best way to do that, I would say.
All right, so another tip that I wanted to give you guys. These tins are very important to keep. These are usually about $20 to $30, depending on the size of them. It's important that you guys keep these because you can use them as a lot of storage, you know, for your cards or for card sleeves, which is what I want to touch on. So these card sleeves right here, you can use them if you're not going to put stuff inside a binder, but I have another use for them as well. So as you can see here, I have an Alakazam EX. Now, not only is that inside one of these pages, but as you can tell, I've gone ahead and put them inside one of these card sleeves. And that's just to protect the integrity of that card. If you're a collector that's maybe looking to sell these cards later on in the future, I think this is the best way that you can protect these cards, just because it adds another layer of protection to that. All right, so for some of you guys that saw last week's videos, we did open up some cards, and I have them right here. These are some team-up cards. I'm just going to use these as an example of how to organize the cards. So this binder right here has my team-up cards. The way that I have it organized is by date of release. So team-up is one of the more recent packs, so you're going to find it more towards the end. As you can see, you know, the only thing that follows this is Unbroken Bonds, since it's one of the even more recent packs. And then I have a couple of Detective Pikachu cards in there as well. If you need a guide on how to find, when the pack was released, Bulbapedia, I believe, has a list of when all the cards were released. Now, this is one way that you can organize it. It's just more of like an extension for me. That way I know, hey, I'm looking for Unbroken Bonds, so let me go all the way to the end because it was one of the more, you know, recently released packs. You don't necessarily have to do it like that, so long as you keep it in order of, you know, Team Up, Fates Collide, you know, whatever, as long as you have them all as part of the packs in order. But, like I said, it just makes it a lot easier if you're going through three or four binders and you're wondering, hey, where's this card pack in? So, we're already here at Team Up. We're going to go ahead and give this Vulpix her slot. And then one thing you can also look for, guys, is, as you can see, when you put them in number order, so like you can see 11 here for Charmander, 12 for this Charmander, 13 for Charmeleon, it usually keeps them by types as well. So you have all the fire types. We know Vulpix is a fire type, so we know they're going to be generally around this area. So rather than having to look through the number, a lot of the times you can just scroll through the pages until you find the fire. So we're looking at this Vulpix card here, and that's number 15. So as we can see here, we don't have 15. So that's going to end up right there. And that's its spot right there. So one thing that I will recommend is if you're opening up card booster packs, try not to let them all pile up for a very long time, because organizing Pokemon cards can take a very long time, especially if you let those cards add up. So if you decide to open, for example, like today we're going to open up 12 booster packs, try to organize them all that same day. If not, leave them for a day that you have a little bit more time. But, you know, try to stay away from letting them pack up, because if you get more than this, for example, right here, it could take a while. So that basically concludes all the tips that I have for you guys. If you guys would like a more in-depth description or a more in-depth videos, just let me know. Just comment down a question that you guys have specifically, and I'll try my best to answer that on the comments. Or if it's something that I feel like I need to make a separate video for, I'll do my best to do that as well. So like I promised you guys earlier, I do have some cards that I'm gonna open for you guys. We were at Walmart today. We picked up some Unbroken Bond packs, some Team Up, and then I found these Roaring Skies, which you usually don't see too much. And these come with 5 cards inside and a booster pack. So we're gonna get straight to opening these up. Hopefully we can get through all of them. And then I got some organizing after this to do. So we got 4 booster packs for Team Up, 4 booster packs for Unbroken Bonds, and then we're gonna save the Roaring Skies for the end, since I don't really have too many of these. So let's go ahead and get started with Team Up. Again, we're trying to get that tag team Gengar and Mimikyu. All right, so we got Larvitar, Psyduck, Bullaby, Weedle, Helioptile, Holographic Weedle, Starmie, Fairy Energy, Cosmoem, Dragonair, Ingo and Emmett, and the code card. All right, so moving on to the next one. Oh, this one didn't open too well. All right, so we got Emolga, Mary, Vulpix, Joltik, Blitzel, Alolan Graveler Holographic, Moltres Holographic, Fire Energy, Tauros, Torracat, Kabuto, and the code. All right, so still no pulls from this team up. We got two packs left. Hopefully the tides turn on this one. All right. So we got Klefki, Charmander, Mankey, Litten, Emolga, Ponyard Holographic, Galvantula, Fairy Energy, Dragonair, another Ingo and Emmett, Charmeleon, and the code card. Alright, so really, really bad luck to start off with. I mean, some of these cards I've already gotten before, and I can honestly tell you I haven't bought too many team-up packs. If you were to look through my collection right now for team-up, I'm missing a lot of cards. Team-up and Unbroken Bonds, so let's hope we get something new. Something good. Ponyard, Staryu, Honedge, Weedle, that's a new one. Dratini, Holographic Litten. Whoops, skip that one. Oh, Ampharos GX. I almost skipped the most important card that we wanted to get in this pack. So there's our first GX pull. That's Ampharos GX. We're gonna put this off to the side. And actually, I'm gonna go ahead and sleeve that up real quick. Because like I mentioned earlier in the video, when this goes in my binder, it's gonna already be pre-sleeved. So we're not done with this pack just yet. We got Fire Energy, Nanu, Hitmonlee, Duoblade, and the code card. All right, so not too bad. One GX pull, four team up. All right, so Unbroken Bond is up next. Hopefully we can at least average one GX for these four. I'll be happy with honestly just one GX, because I feel like if I ask for more, I'm gonna get nothing. And that's happened a lot before in card pack openings. I just get nothing. So if I can continue one GX for each pack, that'll be perfect. All right, so sorry about that sloppiness. We got Oddish, Zubat, Koffing, Doduo, Poliwag, Holographic Wooper, Melmetal, Fire Energy, Porygon 2, Martial Arts Dojo, Fairy Charm, and the code card, which is backwards. Okay, so we're gonna put these off to the side. Move right on to the next one. These packs are not being nice to me today, as you can see. They're just not opening the way I want to. All right, here's the code card. We got Alolan Diglett, Zubat, Jigglypuff, Bellsprout, Diglett, Poliwag. Ooh, Kartana, that's an Ultra Beast card. Leaf Energy, Stealthy Hood, Chatot, Electromagnetic Radar, and that's that for that one. So I had to pause the video because my dog started barking. I don't know if you guys caught it in that last scene. But anyways, we got two Unbroken Bond packs left. Nothing in the first two. these. I tell you, this is like the worst opening I've had with these packs. Like, they usually come out pretty easily and pretty clean, but they are just not working with me today. All right, so we have Venonat, Spearow, Jigglypuff, Krabby, Riolu, Butterfree, Aggron, that's a nice looking Aggron, Psychic Energy, Dust Island. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce it. It's like Pyukumuku. Fire Crystal and the code. Okay, one unbroken bond pack left. Now on the team up, we did get the GX on the last pack. So let's see if we can do the same thing for this one. If we get a GX for this one, I will be so happy. But really, I'm just looking forward to getting a GX on the Roaring Skies, because I can tell you I barely have opened any of those packs. So we got Litten, Clefairy, Seal, Liger, Mischievous, Carvana, Blacephalon, Metal Energy, Power Plant, Charge a Bug, Toracat. So nothing for this unbroken bond packs. All right, so down to our last four packs, Roaring Skies. These are really nice looking packs. I love seeing the Rayquaza and the Deoxys. It reminds me of the Destiny Deoxys movie. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get started with the Mega Latios one. All right, these should all be new cards right here. Nincada, Hidove, Dunsparce, Voltorb, Pikachu, Skyfield, Articuno, that's definitely a new one, Altaria, Wide Lens, Manectric, and the code card. And now these packs did come with a separate five cards. As I showed you guys earlier, the box that they came in, it came with five cards on top of it. But nothing good was pulled from those. It was just a lot of uncommons, so that's why I didn't bother to feature them on here. All right, moving on to the second one. We got Binnacle, Hawlucha, Cascoon, Meowth, Natu, Banette, that's a full art. Nice, another full art. Articuno. Special Energy. Latios Spirit Link. Ultra Ball. And the code card. Alright, I'm a little worried, guys. We got two packs left. We've opened up a total of 10 packs. And we have only gotten one GX, which is our Ampharos. So, these two packs can change it. We can still pull GXs from these last two. So I'm really hoping that we get something good. Something that makes it all worth it at this point. Because right now our luck is not so good. All right, so we got another Hawlucha, Dratini, Inkay, Natu. Not two again. Zekrom. Altaria Full Art. Mega Turbo. Tropius. Switch. And the code card. Oh no, I'm sweating now. We are down to our last pack, and we are not going to waste any time. We're going to just get straight to it. Alright, let's hope for something. Bagon, Pidove, Swablu, Wurmple, Nincada, Holographic Talo, Shedinja, Trainer's Mail, Manectric, special energy, and that was it, guys.
Guys, so as you can see, we didn't have too much luck today. We only pulled one Ampharos GX, which we have sleeved up here. We're gonna continue trying. We got Unified Minds, which is the new card booster pack that's coming out on August 2nd. However, there is one more thing that I do wanna talk about in this video, which I didn't include in the beginning, and that's ordering single cards online, old, you know, vintage booster packs. All of that I do through a website called trollandtoad.com. The link for that is gonna be down below. So today, I'm gonna go ahead and place an order for a lot of vintage cards. And next video that I release, I'm gonna show you guys some of the vintage cards that I have as of right now. And hopefully, if by then some of the new cards that I've ordered have come in, we'll show you guys that as well. Otherwise, stay tuned for the video after that and just continue watching my videos. Like, comment, and subscribe. If you guys like seeing this, just let me know how I can improve, guys. Thanks.